To focus then to some earnings reactions, Sonata Software has shown a steady performance this quarter. Margins have improved, but the one disappointment has come in on the top line, which has slipped by 10%. Prasanna Oke, the CFO of the company, now joins in to detail those numbers. Hi, Mr. Oke. Good afternoon, sir, and thanks very much for your time this afternoon. My first question, in fact, is about your top line, because other than that, one cannot find much to complain about. What is the reason that we've seen this 10% fall in revenues?
Thanks, Sumaira and Prashant. Actually, our business is split up into two parts. One is a domestic part where we measure ourselves on the margin. The other part is the international IT services part where we look at a top line. So if you really look at the international business side of it, we grown quarter on quarter by about 4% in the rupee terms and 6.5% in the dollar terms. On the margins, when we look at it, both these divisions have grown in terms of the margins. The domestic business, so often we have deals which could be of lesser revenues but more margins. So both these businesses have actually grown up in margins. On an index basis, we've grown up by about 21% on the bottom line. Even the business that we talk about, which has degrown in revenues, has actually grown up by about 3% in the margins. So, Sumaira, it's just a function of these two businesses being treated separately and not only on the revenues.
Right. Mr. Oke, so in your presentation, you highlight that 30% of your international service revenues are essentially now digital, right?
Yes, Prashant.
But what all have you sort of added to get to that 30% plus number?
Yeah, so Prashant, what we do is that we look at all our projects and anything which comprises the mobility, e-commerce, analytics, BI is what we club as our digital revenues. So that is about 31%. What we also look at is our IP-led revenues. Sonata is also having its own IPs where we try to create a digital transformation for our clients through what we call as platformation. These revenues that we consider are about 14% have grown up, as compared on a sequential quarter basis. This is where we try to transform the client's business through the IP that we have and moving them towards the platformation route. So that's another measure that we will be measuring going ahead from now.
The question was this sort of digital, what was the revenues from digital, say, a year back? You're at 31% now. And what implications does this have?
Right, Prashant. So about a year back, if you look at about four quarters back, we were about 25% of our revenues, or the total revenues used to come in from digital. All it says is that we are attuned to the needs of the clients where a lot of digital transformation is going on. They are using more and more digital technologies, which includes mobility, AI, analytics, e-com, etc. And we are clued into that. And as a percentage of our business, those component of our revenues are growing.
Okay. So now that your SG&A investments are over in FY17 and given the little or no pricing pressure because of your high digital exposure, how much do you think headroom do you have in terms of your margins from here?
Sumaira, if we look at it, we believe that we did make our investments into our S&M and IP, etc. through last year. All these are kind of baked in. So we believe that we are well positioned to be, growing on the top line and the bottom line. However, we are seeing pressures as all other IT companies are doing on account of the appreciating rupee. As a short answer, yes, we do believe that most of our costs are baked in at this point of time.
Okay. So just one more question. I wanted to check this report over here which indicates that there's a royalty payment dispute which is ongoing with the IT department. Could you give us a sense of, what's the progress on that front? Because I believe it figures also in your contingent liabilities.
Right, Sumaira. I mean, this has been an issue going on for quite a while. It's a contingent liability. There are a few cases which have happened which, we are, working out. We have won quite a few of them in the High Court and the Supreme Court. Typically, we see that there's an appeal which happens back from the IT department. It's an industry issue. And we have, as a proper guidance, we have put them in the contingent liabilities at this point of time.
All right, Mr. Oke, thanks very much. Good speaking with you. Appreciate you joining in with those comments, post numbers, and good luck. Thank you. We'll take a very quick break.